All right, my friends, what's up? We're back. More Arena, sponsored by Wizards. Thanks so much for Wizards for giving me a whole bunch of booster packs and gems and stuff on Arena. They did an awesome job with their Arena rollout. Arena's a lot of fun. There's still some kinks. Still some things need to be worked on. But overall, they're in the right direction for sure. And it's a lot of fun. It's really cool. And we're playing some of the decks in the Pro Tour. We just played the LSV Channel Fireball, a Giant's Pride Mate White Weenie deck to a 5-0. Now we're trying out a deck that's a little bit weirder. This is a big red deck from the Pro Tour. Looks a little similar to Mono Red. However, it looks to be a deck that's built to beat the white decks. We're playing Goblin Chain Whirler. We're playing, you know, Lightning Strike, Firebrand. Otherwise, there's not really any creatures in this deck besides Phoenixes and Demanding Dragons. We have four main deck Fiery Cannonades, four main deck Lava Coil, four main deck Electrostatic Field, a card usually seen in the burn deck. So this deck is kind of smart in a lot of ways, honestly. It just seems really, really good against white, and the white decks are obviously very popular. And then I guess the Banefires are just sort of like, how are you going to beat control with our four Fiery Cannonade deck? I know, let's play four Banefires. So I'm not going to lie, I'm pretty surprised this deck is not playing Treasure Map. Because map seems like perfect for a deck like this. But this deck seems very good against creatures, and it has Banefires for the non-creature matchups. And four Demanding Dragon is interesting. This card was bugged on Moto for a while, and they had to sacrifice. It was really good. But interesting card. Phoenix is obviously great. Chain Whirler is obviously great. Cannonade's obviously great against the white decks. Our sideboard gives us the fourth Firebrand, four Lightning Mare. I guess against control decks and the blue decks. Seems like it's mono blue, I suppose. Sorcerer Spyglass, four Fight with Fire, two Legion War Boss, two Risk Factor. So, interestingly enough, there's no Experimental Frenzies and no Treasure Maps anywhere near this deck, which are two cards that I would expect to try. But this deck went 6-4 at the Pro Tour, and it looks cool, so let's try it out. Competitive, constructed, of course. Big red, let's battle. We're giving away promo codes for Arena all day on stream, so make sure you check that out. And of course, don't forget to check out my new promo codes, coolstuffinc.com, my home on the web. Videos Monday, articles Friday, check it out. Use code GYM5 to get 5% off your next order. Buy your Ultimate Masters box or other games, Settlers of Catan, Star Realms, you name it. And then of course, BCW, Team BCW, Deck Art Elite Sleeves, Deck Locker, Deck Boxes, Binders, you name it, 10% off with code GYM10 at bcwsupplies.com. New promo codes, and we're rocking it. Let's go here. Double Demanding Dragon. We're on the draw with a field and a cannonade and a Banefire. I'm going to keep. Free packs in Arena are coming. We'll keep those packs flowing all stream. Don't you worry, all right? Druid of the Cowl, little greenback. Greenback's been very, very popular on Arena so far today. Airheads? Airheads are good. I like them. I'm a fan. Turn 3 Karn? That seems exceptionally good against us. We are definitely not very aggressive, and this thing can deal damage to not planeswalkers. That's tilt. Okay. Yeah, I mean, turn 3 Karn on the play seems like the best possible play against this deck because we're not that aggressive. Chupacabra's going to handle our Demanding Dragons pretty easily. This could be tough. This could definitely be tough.
Nothing is ever truly lost.
They're going to get Vraska. They're going to kill our field. This is bad. Yeah. Alright. Green Black was the most played deck at the Pro Tour. So might be why this deck went 6-4. Jeez. I guess we're Banefiring the Vraska. not cool, but... Don't let it go to your head. Scorpion. They have Carnage Tyrant here, too. Have all the perfects. Find Finality or Jade Light Ranger. Well, they have no graveyard. I think Find Finality is fine. It doesn't really do much. It would be cool if I could have the foreign text cards, but hover when they come up English. Oh, they have Carnage Tyrant. Alright, well, it seems like we're dead. This is a turn 5 Carnage Tyrant. Turn 3 Karn, turn 4 Vraska, turn 5 Carnage Tyrant. Yeah. Jared.
CH.
I demand things of you. We could punk him out with like a main fire and some attacks, maybe. Codes are coming. It took 5? Alright. They can have a swamp. A chupacabra. Jared, thank you. Korgon, new sub. What's up, my friend? Welcome. What's your name? Where are you from? Oh my god. This is just unreal. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. We are dead on board. Yeah, I mean. Deck techs will be, I can do deck techs, but they'll be after this league is done. Not looking so good so far. It took 10. Cannonade only kills 2 things. Your best chance to win is them to just, like, not have an answer to this. We just Ak and Banefire them. Obviously, they have an answer, so. Okay, we're dead. That was a rough game. little arrow, that was cool. Yep, deck techs are still on. Donation bonus leagues will return next week. I'm flying to Vegas on Thursday for the Open, and this week it's not really in the cards. Alright, Demanding Dragon seems terrible in this matchup. And quite frankly, none of our cards seem very good in this matchup, honestly. Cannonade's actually fine. It kills all the small creatures. Firebrand does not seem very good. Risk Factor seems fine. Fight with Fire doesn't seem great. Obviously, having Cannonade and War Boss in the same deck feels awkward, but I like the fields. I can buy field. Firebrand is. They didn't show Llanowar Elves. They only showed the 1/3. They probably have Llanowar Elves. Lava Coil is like shaveable, I think. Demanding Dragon is also not great. The codes are coming! Alright, they're coming. Free codes, free booster packs on Arena. Patience, my friends, patience. I mean, Demanding Dragon's like pretty bad. I'm gonna cut a dragon for a fourth Firebrand. Oh, the factors aren't in. Bring the factors. Like, Lava Coil is, like, not super necessary. We find ways to kill our creatures. Yeah, we're gonna put Lava Coils out. I think this is okay. I'm not really sure, honestly. Weird. It's a weird deck and a weird sideboard. Went 6-4 at the Pro Tour, so it can't be too bad, but...
Holy crap, dude!
It's not going to be a full 12-hour stream, you know, with John sick and stuff and whatever. We'll go for a long time. Alright. Phoenix is very good against them, so that's good. Kalkari Guildgate, nice. Druid of the Cowl, dead. Light him up. Alright, I mean, hopefully no Veracity Contempt. Not playing treasure map is pretty weird. Find finality also in the bin. How long is the code for BCW good for? Use it and find out. Should be good for a bit. Cool. No contempt, no contempt, no contempt, no contempt. Cool.
Alive or alive.
Wow. Sacking their fourth land. That is quite aggressive. I guess we're attacking the Veraska. What's up, tap land? Alright, well, we have... seven lands and a Banefire, which I guess is the worst cards to have than Banefire when you have seven lands, but these four Banefires are pretty weird, I'm not gonna lie. Assassin's Trophy on top. Grayson!
Hey Jim, any chance y'all could give me some advice on a sideboard for an upcoming event?
Deck text for $10. You do that. Alright. If it's quick, like one sentence of advice, we can do that too. Suppose Banefire is good against Assassin's Trophy. Fanatical Firebrand is here. Oh, we have a Chupacabra. Banefire is cool and all, but we can't fireball for the full 20. And we're going to need some other things going on, too. Dunkin' Dinos? I'll do Dunkin' Dinos at some point today. Yeah, it's Chupacabra. Hashtag sponsored. Goblin Chain Whirler. If three cards in hand... a Jade Light in the bin with a Memorial to Folly. Feels bad. Chupacabra. This matchup seems really bad. Just throwing that out there. We do have a Banefire in our hand, though. Maybe we should cut some of the Banefires. I don't even know. LeBrontodon James. No attack. They should obviously attack with their Chupacabras. They have a Memorial in their in play and a Midnight Reaper in play. Nah, no Frenzy. Deckwiz is on the Stream Decker overlay. What are they getting back? The Jade Light Ranger? Alright. BCW code to give the rest of the month. Alright, we're gonna have to block the Reaper. Don't fear the Reaper! Yeah.
Let's see if you're worth. You can't stop nature.
Stop being so mean to me. I mean, we are 1,000% dead. That's actually not the worst. So you're saying there's a chance here. Cannonade kills Chupacabra, Chupacabra, and Brontodon before damage. They have Jade Light Ranger. Might kill that too. 10. 7 mana to kill Vivian. And 3 mana for Cannonade. Alright. So you're saying there's a chance. 7, we're on 7, right? Oh, 6, yes. X is 6, target this.
Oh, so it's going to be like that, huh?
Yeah, it is actually going to be like that. Stop being mean to me, right? You're very rude. Yeah, that's pretty good. Don't fear the reap. I guess they, like... We're going to deal a lot of damage to them. But I think we're, in trouble here. Upstairs. Alright, this matchup seems really, really bad. Not gonna lie. That's our first loss. And we're playing the, you should be able to see your deck list on this screen. Playing our big red deck. Back at it. There's no maps. Again, this is a deck from the Pro Tour. This deck went 6-4 at the Pro Tour. The list looked weird. I figured I would try it, but it does seem very soft to green black. So seems very, very good against the red deck. I mean the white decks. Against the red mirror too. Against any history of Benalia deck or aggressive red deck or even mono blue, this deck seems great. With main deck cannonades and chain whirlers and stuff, but beating a... I clicked it, nothing happened. But beating a green black with this deck seems tough. Booster pack codes. Yeah, you guys are being impatient. If I see 45 Mr. Destructoid emotes in chat, I'll give 2 codes away. Nerds rope. God damn it. Never mind. Alright, codes are coming. Codes are coming. Here come those codes. Four more codes are coming. Bam. Open your arena, put that code in, and River Sneak is here. And I'm going to Banefire this for one. This Banefire is not getting much better than this. Booster pack codes are in chat. What are the codes for? One booster pack on Arena of Guilds of Ravnica for free. Electrostatic field. Cool. This deck seems to be lacking a draw engine. Which is why I'm very surprised it's not playing Treasure Map. I get why it's not playing Frenzy. I get why it's not playing Frenzy. Because Frenzy does seem out of place with like more expensive cards. But Treasure Map seems perfect for this deck. Q. Wild card, sweet. Tell us what you got in chat. Jungleborn Pioneer, sure. Block. 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 I demand things of you. Yes, Rick, I agree. We're going to take a moment of silence right now. A stream moment of silence for the passing of Stan Lee, a literal modern day legend. Everyone, take a second. Moment of silence. Shut up, Arena. For real. Grew up on X-Men. I'm really enjoying all the Marvel movies. If your life amounts to 1% of what Stan Lee's life amounted to, you've done a good job. Because at 95 years old, he altered the entire landscape of the world. So Stan Lee, Godspeed, my friend. Alright, let's get back to it here. I can't even be sad, because he was 95, and he just had such an amazing life, you know? Are they dead? Yeah, they're just dead, right? Upstairs. What? Oh, I was counting my mana. My bad. I thought I had four mountains open. I only had three. That was cool. You did. I mean, Merfolk is a pretty bad deck, so we should be. We're also like the anti-creature decks. We should be pretty fine here. Get ready for game two. We can add a Firebrand and chill on a Banefire. Maybe add a nothing. This seems fine. Yeah, it's sad. At least he was in the he's in the new Avengers, right? So they already filmed it. So Nerds Rope. Look at this, Candy Perfection. That's a mulligan. We're bottom that. We need lands. defense. This fiery cannonade is looking real good. Nerd rope is so good. Oh my god. Yeah, this is a brutal massacre. Odds my opponent concedes on the spot. What do you think? Yep. So we're sort of at expectation a little bit right now. This deck seems very, very good against creature decks and seems bad against green black. We got a card. Exclusion Mage. That card's good. We're 1-1. We're playing Big Red. If you're streaming, welcome to the stream. If you haven't followed the stream, hit that follow button, of course. Watching on YouTube, make sure you follow in there. Also, check out one of my sponsors, BCW, of course. Team BCW is my squad. BCW is a great supply company. Awesome gaming line, deck art elite sleeves, deck lockers, zipper binders, tons of high quality stuff. 10% off with code JIM10 at bcwsupplies.com. Check it out, bcwsupplies.com. And a mulligan.
Hi.
Well, also when you use BCW sleeves, you actually never mulligan. They have anti-mulliganing plastic built into them. It's pretty cool. Thanks. We're going to top this and just hope they're playing creatures. Sweet. Good top, Jim. Bird. All right, that's fun. Nope. Don't think I can say that legally.
Hey, Jim, love your content, and I'm so glad I was able to sub to you. And congrats on the Cool Stuff Inc. partnership.
Thank you, Snarky Butt Munch. I appreciate that. Happy to have you sub and appreciate that. What's up, Bob? When I was in college at Stony Brook University, I had a radio show on WUSB Stony Brook 90.1 FM college radio every Monday from 3 to 5 called Say What's Radio. It was a lot of fun. I think we're in great shape here. Play a second field. Cast Cannonade. Firebrand can kill a 3-3 if necessary. Bird. That's a card, I guess. Do not fear, my friend. Well, thankfully they did it wrong, so that's fine. What I, see in you. I still get to kill their things, but they just have this Ajani in play. So that's really bad for us. Okay, we say go. Us chapter 2. Yeah, so I guess we just do it now. Jeez. Where did you just the host, or did you do all the AVV stuff? What? I was just the DJ. Alright. Planeswalkers are obviously a problem for us, as we're seeing. This is not a common main deck card. Usually don't play, these decks don't play Ajani in the main deck, and it's about to destroy us, so. Mountain. Healer's Hawk. Knight of Grace. Yeah.
Look how far.
And now we're 1 point short of killing it with Banefire. God. Why can't this thing hit Planeswalkers too? too short, actually. I'm stupid. Alright. I guess we just say go. This thing ultimate soon, like... I guess we can just lightning strike the Ajani and then Banefire it next turn. That feels awful. Yeah, Banefire is not looking very good. Sky Marcher Aspirant. Oh my god. I think we're dead.
Strength is born of struggle.
Oh, sorry. This is bad. At least we dealt them 2 damage. Yeah, these Banefires look like crap. What's the worst experience I've had with playing professional Magic? You gotta elaborate on that. Probably answering dumb questions in chat. I'm kidding. Ask me a more specific question than that. Like with actually playing in tournaments or playing on stream, what do you mean? Banefire just seems terrible. We want Fight with Fires, I guess? Firebrand, Fight with Fire. All Banefires are gone. I guess that's it. Warboss seems bad with Cannonade. Yeah, it's okay, but bad with Cannonade. Alright, let's try this, I guess. I don't mind the fourth Fight with Fire, but I don't know if I want to cut for it. There's no 4 of copy limit on cards. How would standard change? What would be the best deck? Yeah, I mean, obviously, some burn deckers playing a bunch of lightning strikes. Honestly, maybe, a deck with like 18 swamps and 42 copies of the Lightning Helix. This hand's bad. In tournaments, root opponents, bad venues. I just take it all in stride, honestly. I just take everything at face value at this point. Like, you know, I don't really recall any specific instance or whatever. I've played some PTQs where, like, we had to play, like, in the basement, you know, like, on the floor, practically. That's pretty tough, but it's not really like that anymore. That was a long time ago. Yeah, we're gonna mulligan. Sounds better. They also mulliganed. I'm gonna bottom that. I'm trying to draw a land for Cannonade. Alright, I mean, we're like reasonably well set up here. Double Cannonade. Danto Vanguard is annoying, but fine. We have all the answers to it for the most part. Pretty happy to just like deal them 4 here. Or 5, I suppose. One Whirly Boy. Hey, guess what? Another Arena Booster Code in chat. Bam! Put that code in Arena. Get a free booster pack. You're welcome. Conclave Tribunal. Could be worse. I feel like his deck just isn't getting anywhere. Like, without the aggressive start, we're more of a control deck. And we don't really have, like, the card draw engine or planeswalkers that a control deck would usually have. I almost think Karn would be fine in his deck. This deck doesn't have a way to draw cards and get ahead. You know, treasure map, Karn. Like, if you're playing four maps and three Karns, or, like, three and three instead of a Dragons, and something else, maybe we would, like, be able to get along a little better. But we're kind of just, like, we play this wall, and we kill some things, and then what? You know? Belcher Mage, thanks for the sub, appreciate that, welcome. Sarkhan? Not huge on Sarkhan. It's one code per person, so I'm gonna use this now. Does five to them, kills their things. Frenzy is awkward with the more expensive cards, though. So I get that. I get why there's no Frenzy in the deck, you know? Banefire just seems bad, and the dragon seems bad. So... alright. I mean, we're kind of doing it. Where was Red-Black Burn at the Pro Tour? I don't know. It seems bad against white, I guess. You know, like, there's, like, the always life gain in the white deck, so... Tribunal on our wall, or field. Do I want a cannonade in response? Try and deal five? I do. Mythic Wildcard must be nice. Alright, this is fun. They can have my field. Let's draw a dragon or something. Phoenix, please. That's a mountain. Perhaps we blew our load a little too early on that, cannonade. I don't know, it's not that bad. Yeah. I think we're gonna fix this deck and play it again. It's interesting that some pro... Don is throwing shade in chat. Don says, it's really interesting that some pro came to the Pro Tour with this deck after assumedly a lot of testing. Yeah, I agree. This deck went 6-4 at the Pro Tour, and it seems really bad. But, I think there's an idea here, and then we're going to work on it. So... that's it. Two losses. We're dead already, right? We're going to fix this deck and play again. Two losses. Claim prize. We get a rare. We get a Rupture Spire. Why is it the bland color, not like the gold color? Fire Cannon and the ban. All right. Okay. We're going to fix this. We can fix this. Alright, first things first, treasure map. Oh, we gotta craft some of these. Craft them! Three maps. Three Karn or four Karn? Ooh boy, Mythic Wild Cards, let's go.
I will defend my allies. Until you have lived as a statue.
Three Karn. Dragons are gone. Banefires are gone. That's 58. Maybe just four map, four Karn, honestly. Look at me, I'm spending all my wild cards for you fine folks. Oh, whoops. And then, I don't like the Firebrands either. What can we play over Firebrand? I don't mind playing some Shocks. Frenzy, Labyrinth. Demand Dragon kind of sucks, honestly. New subs. Belcher Mage and Bob. Bob is Andrew from Bay Area. Playing since Theros, favorite card Elspeth. Favorite deck Narsa Cannon. In Origin Standard. And then Name the Puppy Racer. Sweet. Andrew, thank you, my friend. Appreciate it. We didn't trim the burn. We just cut the four Banefires. We still have all these spells. I like Field a lot, actually. I almost want some more spells in the deck to make Field better. What if we play, like, two Shocks and, like, a Frenzy or two? Alright, let's try this. Let's do that. Two Shocks, Frenzy, and we'll cut, one Karn. We'll go to three Karn. And then we're going to cut that. I like War Boss for control matchups. I don't really get these Lightning Mares, honestly. They seem pretty peculiar. Spyglass is also seems unnecessary. Frenzy and Karn don't go amazing together, but they're kind of fine. Risk Factor seems bad, I agree. I like War Boss. Field of Ruin, you can't play in a Chain Whirler deck, I don't think. We just don't really need it. Mare, Fight with Fire, Legion War Boss, Frenzy, Banefire, kind of Fight with Fire. Alright, let's try this, okay? How do I export this, though? Banefire is no longer the picture. Can I export this as a text file? Apparently I can. Cool. Alright, let's try again. With our fixed big red deck. It's not pasting. Alright, well, I can't upload the thing to StreamDecker until I figure this out, because I screwed it up. So, after this game, we'll do it. Alright, I already like this deck a lot better. Keep. It's not bigger than the dragons? Yeah, it is. Fix the big red. Oh, you want more codes? Is that what you want? You want more codes, huh? Fine. There's another code, alright? You happy? More booster pack codes. Commune with dinosaurs. Put a field, I guess. Map is basically a 3-drop anyway because you want to use it immediately, so. Phoenixes are medium. Medium red? Medium red just sounds worse, you know? Alright, They are ramping the dinosaurs. Is Burnsy sleeping? Question. When's their codes to give out? Question. Don't be so demanding. Jeez. Catch more flies with honey than vinegar. The dragon sucks. It's a 5-5 for 5. You know, just not very good. Deafening clarion, sweet. Ripdraw Raptor is so good against us, it is not even real. One booster per code, yeah. I'll upkeep stop. Okay. It's fine, we're just slamming Phoenix anyway, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's one code per account, so. Yeah, Raptor's so good against red decks.
Holy crap, dude!
It's basically 5-5 or 5. Dice Chupacabra. Doesn't. The problem is that we're not affecting the board a ton. We need things that. Oh my god. Savage Stomp. Well, they didn't draw a card, at least. Alright. I want them drawing a card, so... Hey, y'all got any more of them codes? Oh, Joe Rogan, you crazy. I can't hear all of them. Huh. Interesting. Upkeep. Scry. Karn. Top? Draw. Oh, we're still gonna have to main phase. Karn plus is probably good. Yeah, I like that.
Our actions depend on the certain of your decision.
Lightning strike or land? Land. Okay. We can always block with the Ripdraw with a field, just chump block if we have to. It's planting flowers. Oh, flower bug thing.
Just wait longer.
Man, they were like casting Communion Dinosaurs. What's up, TWP? How's it going, my friends? If you're tuning in, welcome to the stream. Carnage Tyrant. Please don't have a land. If you're tuning in, welcome to the stream. My name is Jim Davis. Sponsored Wizards stream. Thanks to Wizards of the Coast today. Thanks so much, my friends at Wizards. They gave you a bunch of gems and packs and stuff. And we're playing some Arena, having a great time. So I was the streamer of the day in Arena. Well, welcome, my friends. Welcome. Playing some Arena. We 5-0'd with LSV's awesome white weenie deck from the Pro Tour. Now we're trying out a big red deck from the Pro Tour that went 6-4. The first version seemed bad. We 1-2'd. So I fixed it. All right, I'm going to kill my treasure map. It's fine. Fiery Cannonade is pretty bad. This card's so good against us. All right, we're going to plus this.
Holy crap, dude.
We don't want that lightning strike, do we? Maybe we do want the lightning strike, actually.
Welcome aboard.
We need to not die to Carnage Tyrant. And we need to kill them. Strike plus field is a turn off the clock. Blocking and cannonading. I mean, that will kill the Raptor, but they're just going to cast a Carnage Tyrant. I guess that plays. It plays Carnage Tyrant. And sets 14. The wall can soak up some of it. Yeah, I actually like that. Let's do that.
You may regret that choice.
They will draw two cards off it, but... Right. Two.
Welcome aboard.
That's, I guess, Tyrant. We get to attack again next turn and Karn again. Yeah. Alright, this is fun. Magic's a hard game. The more you play, the more you learn. The more you learn, the better you get. Alright, so we block. Cannonade. Take one. They draw a card. Stinks, which is fine. They slam Carnage Tyrant. We get to get our Lightning Strike off our Karn. Attack for four with the Phoenix. We have Lava Coil to deal one later. The field does protect us a little bit. So they have Deafening Clarion here, it sucks. We probably could beat that card anyway, honestly. So that's pretty scary. It's post-combat though, right? Oh, yeah, alright. That does give their... Wow, that's actually insane for us. So now we get his Lava Coil, this Alpha, and we're in great shape. This is fantastic. I mean, Nicole's at work all day, so... Lava Coil, that bad boy. And that swings the clock heavily in our favor. Gonna get our Lightning Strike this turn. Play map. Play land. Attack all. The codes are coming. Now they have Carny T, but nowhere to go with it. You want another code? Alright, codes in chat. Free booster pack code in chat. Yeah, Magic is really, really, really hard. I'll block. Karn on top? No. Upstairs. Codes are one redemption per code, once per account. Don't breathe on me.
Excellent. 10 points to Griffin.
They're dead. We actually had a shock under our Karn anyway, so. Sweet. Deck obviously much improved. Everything I thought turns to gold. Alright, I guess we're bringing these Fight with Fires. Fire Cannonade seems much, or not great in this matchup. Fight with Fires in. Shock also seems mopey. What are these War Bosses in, actually? We have four War Bosses? Wow, that's a lot. I think we're going to need to be a little more aggressive, because their top end of Carnage Tyrant just kind of kills us. So... Field does block a lot of their stuff pretty well. I'm going to cut these shocks. I'm going to cut one Karn, I think, also. I think two Frenzy's fine. Let's try this. Kind of just winging it here. I like the idea of War Boss because we can, like, threaten them and kill their stuff while making tokens and attacking. Like, they're not going to play anything big or reasonable to a turn, like, 4 or 5. We have Fight with Fire and Lava Coil to kill stuff, so... I'm honestly not exactly sure how the codes work. Monkey Head Games, that's a real, real long time ago. Yeah, Monkey Head was Brothers Grimm before Grimm. My first ever game store experience was at Monkey Head. And I was 14, maybe. Play Magic for like a month or two. And our friend Gavin, his older brother, was 18. And he drove us to Monkey Head for an F&M. We had no idea what Standard was. We had no idea what anything was. And it was one of the worst experiences I've ever had. And I didn't go back to a store for like 6 years because of it. Went to the store, didn't know what F&M was. No one at the store told us what it was. So we just like asked people to play and they were like, we're playing in the tournament. And then I traded a foil Force Spike and a Lightning Angel for like two Delusions of Mediocrity or something, or whatever, Delusions of, like, the Urza gain 10, lose 10, blue enchantment. I'm gonna keep. So I got totally ripped off on a trade. And then I went to the front and I wanted to see the rare binder. And the person behind the counter could not be bothered with me. They were just like, oh, you wanna look at these rares? Here. Here's the binder. Didn't offer any advice, didn't offer any guidance. It's just like, here, take it. I'm like, alright. I looked through it for a bit. I didn't buy anything. And then I just left. Like, thinking back on it, it blows my mind. How you could run a business so poorly. Like, someone new walks in your store, holy crap, say hi to them. Ask them if they know what's going on, and explain to them what's going on. You know, it's like really not that hard to run a business, like, remotely reasonably well. Like, it's just unbelievable to me. Like, thinking, at the time I was just like, well, I guess this is what stores are like. But, thinking back to it, like, oh my god, this is unbelievable. Alright, we got Phoenixes for days. Yeah. No, that's what a lot of stores are like, and if your store is like that, call them out on it. Because, honestly, there's a lot of socially inept people in the... Oh my god, that's brutal. Savage Stomp? Socially inept people in the industry. And, that shit needs to be called out. I assume they're gonna kill this somehow. You know? No. So what's the point of that Savage Stomp? Just draw a card. Alright, Double Raptor's pretty good. But my Phoenixes are also good. I think we're just racing. Just blocking and racing. Yeah, game stores definitely do not do a good job often of being inclusive and welcoming. It is definitely kind of like a boys club. Like, you know, there's the same 10 people who go to the store, and we go to the store, and this is what we do. And don't bother us kind of thing, you know, which is really stupid. All right, we are super dead this game. Yikes. Yeah, I mean... Look pretty dead to me. If their last card's not good, it might actually be okay here. Nope, it's good. Ripjaw Raptor is very good against us. Really good against us. Star of Extinction is cool. Look how good the 5-5 for 5 would have been here. I mean, yeah. Obviously, there are scenarios where certain cards are good. Alright. Yeah, we're just gonna leave it, I think. Pretty fine running it back. Yeah, maybe I just have good business sense, but like it just flabbergasts me when you look at a business and you just like think, like, how could you possibly think this is the way to run a business, you know? Yeah, I mean, obviously people working in game stores aren't making much money. But just, like, just don't be a douche, you know? Like, just, I don't know. I mean, I'm the kind of person that, if I'm going to do a job, I'm going to do it well. You know, like, I've delivered pizzas, I've worked in delis, you know, like stock boy cleaning when I was younger. You know, I've worked in sales, I've worked in, you know, even like, you know, my retail job at Office Max, I worked for a few years. Just do your job good. Just don't, you know, like, how hard is it to just, like, put in some effort and not be bad at your job, you know? Just be nice. All right, they found a raptor. It sucks. Field is good, though. Right, like, and people definitely don't open stores as, like, a good business move, you know, like, because opening a store is not really a good business move, honestly. You know, there's better ways to make money. And stores are often just sort of, like, passion projects of people who love games, but it's still not that hard. You know? IRE, just keep doing what you're doing. Alright? You know, like, if you're being a positive force in the community, it'll pay off eventually. Right. Card counter Chris is right. You don't have to provide outstanding customer service. Just don't be a dick. You know, like, don't discourage new players and, like, I'm in. You know, don't make people feel excluded. Like, there's a lot of, you know, a lot of people who are picked on when they were younger who play Magic, and they sort of have turned that into a bitterness, and they turn it on others, you know, with a need to feel better and superior and intellectually superior and stuff. And it's really, really poisonous, you know, toxic. Lava coil on my wall. That's one lava coil not on my Phoenix. That's fine. I still want to keep this. I don't have a land, though. I need a land. Yeah, I got a bottom this. It kills the big creature, but... Right? Ugh. Yeah, I don't have a bottom. I just want to draw land. Heh! Scrybug. Even on Arena, we get the Scrybug. Alright. Alright, there's your Ripjaw Raptor. Mountain on top, thank you. Alright. This could be worse. Yeah. Yeah, the bitter nerd is a very common trope, unfortunately. But you gotta ask yourself, you're not making the world better. Are you making the world better with your actions, yes or no? Right. Reach Straw off was good. That card is good. War Boss. We get to War Boss and Lava Coil. Yeah, I could buy War Boss. Armstrong, for sure. Armstrong says sometimes the bitter, socially awkward nerd just needs to be shown some compassion to turn them. Lead by example. Yeah, I mean, it's not untrue. So we draw a card off of our cove here, or do we... Yeah, let me do. Sweet, we drew a land. So I get to go War Boss, Lava Coil, the Alpha, and get him the token. This one feels pretty good. Right. IRE, I think that one of the biggest failings that people have is putting themselves in other people's shoes and just thinking for half a second how it would feel for them, you know? Like, dude behind the counter is annoyed that stupid noob comes in the store and wants to buy some bulk rares for a dollar each. You know, what a waste of my time. If that person just put themselves in my shoes for half a second, 14-year-old kid walks into a magic store for the first time ever and has no idea what's going on, what should I do? You know, like... No Carnage Tyrant, please. Ugh. That's actually fine. Whatever. Kills their thing. We have Karn and stuff, so. Deathgorge Scavenger? Alright. Yeah. The foil Force Spike and Lightning Angel for two Delusions of Mediocrity is perfect, though. Kid, like it's like the most typical scenario. Kid walks into magic store, gets ripped up on trades, treated like crap. No one tells him what's going on, and the store owner's an asshole to him. Just like standard story, you know. All right. 5, 6, 7, 8. I definitely like Karn here. We can strike the scavenger. The codes aren't one-time use? Well, whatever they are, there's codes, and just try and use them. I don't know how they work. No one does. They just work sometimes, and it's cool. Alright, we're going to strike this. I'm interested in making a token here, am I? I'm going to draw a card. Maybe I am, actually. I'll make a token. Lava coil. Alright. Sweet. I guess I'll let them attack. And then I'll let them exile something, so they'd waste some stuff somewhere. I guess they're gonna gain some life here. Eh. Yeah, that's dumb. Whatever. I shouldn't have done that. That was stupid. I should have just killed it. It just gained 2 life for no reason here. That was stupid. Alright. Raptor is good, but beatable. It's definitely not Carnage Tyrant, so that's fine. That's a good draw. Frenzy? Phoenix. 6, 7, 8. Yeah, let's make a token and blow. We can, like, double block this thing. There is great power. Let's cast Frenzy, too. Get it all out there. Top card's Chain Whirler. That card's bad against Raptor. But we'll just double block and see what happens. Now that we have Frenzy online, we're in pretty good shape. I guess we're going to draw, it's not be able to cast it, but... Frenzy's dope. Savage Stomp again. Alright, well, let's just not have a... some other way to... Well, I can't even attack anymore because I have this construct. I draw a card, though. That's pretty good. I mean, I assume they have a follow-up here because killing the Phoenix doesn't do anything by itself. They could have killed the construct. Karn and Frenzy's fine. It's not ideal, but it's fine. It's clear top card. Looks like we're in good shape here. Top card, Lava Coil. Awkward. Because it may or may not kill the Raptor. I guess we're casting it. I really hate to have them draw a card and not be able to kill it. Ugh. I'm just gonna not do this and just draw this into my hand. Or I'm gonna, what's it called? Hit the Karn. A curious choice. Top card, Mountain. Top card, another Karn. I guess that's fine. I'll keep my new Karn.
I battled with the forces.
Top card, Lightning Strike. Upstairs. Top card, Fight with Fire. That's awkward. That's super awkward. Because we can kick it next turn. Might want to just draw that into our hand, actually. But I kind of want to make another 3-3. Or make another token.
Some solutions must be built.
I'm going to say go. So I'll attack with the Phoenix, I guess, but... don't want them to draw cards. Oops. I do want this Fight with Fire in my hand, though, so I can end-step Pop Frenzy and just tend them out of nowhere. Seems like a pretty good way to win the game. Savage Stomp a token. Sure. They want to kill Karn. That's fine.
This will not deter me.
Okay, we're just gonna kill him, I think.
I'm not back in 5 minutes. Just wait a moment.
I'm one short. I'm so stupid. I've heard the shrinks. Whatever. I'm going to play with Chain Whirls, I guess, then. I'll just Chain Whirler twice. And they draw cards, but, like... I guess I could draw Deafening Clarion. Ugh, this is annoying. I'm so stupid. I've heard the shrinks. If I play Chain Whirler and they have Deafening Clarion, they get to gain 6 life and shrink my creatures. I'm just attend them. They just can't win. It doesn't matter. It's fine. Upstairs and say go. Now what? Well, waiting for our opponent here. So we're gonna get some more booster pack codes away. Are you guys cool with that? Booster pack codes for Arena. Enter the code, get one free pack of Guilds of Ravnica. Codes are going in chat right now. You ready? Here they come. Bam. Four codes in chat. Put that code into Arena. Get a free booster pack. Opponents BMing us, I think. So, get a free booster pack on Arena. Put those codes in. One per account. And pick on the draw. Also, while we're waiting for our rude opponent here, I want to remind everybody to check out CoolStuffInc.com. CoolStuffInc.com, of course, is a sponsor of mine as well as my home for on the web. Articles, videos Monday, articles Friday. This Monday's video is all about Rakdos mid-range and standard. And then article Friday will be all about my predictions from the Pro Tour. Check it out, CoolStuffInc.com. Whirly boy. Alright, we're 1-0 with our new version of a deck. I like it. I got a card.
Melvin.
What we get? That is topical. We got a fight with fire.
Hi, Super Nintendo Chalmers.
Cool. And some coins. We're 1-0. I'm going to export this deck list real fast so I can upload it onto the Stream Decker. No, that's some more codes. I said export. Oh, I hit the actual deck. There we go. Oh, that's really annoying. Is that going to work? We did it! 1-0. Let's go. We fixed our deck. Big red. Big red, big red, big red, big red. Get your booster pack codes. Get your booster pack codes. Once again, huge thanks to Wizards of the Coast for sponsoring this stream. They've done an awesome job with their arena rollout, sponsoring streamers, getting everyone involved. It's really, really cool. And, frankly, they're just doing an awesome job. Arena's got some problems. Arena's not perfect yet, but Arena is very, very fun. The intangible stuff, the, like, this is just fun to do, is there. So you can iron out the details later as far as, like, the economy, you know, and, you know, playing with your friends and tournament stuff. That can all be ironed out, but the simple fact that playing Arena is fun is a great success, so. Okay, on the play. We can keep this. I think the map makes it keepable. Turn 2 map, turn 3 upkeep scry if you don't draw land. Hype. Thanks for the codes. Getting the free booster packs. Yes, Arena is fantastic for the game. Tons of new players, tons of Hearthstone players, and players from other games hopping in. It's great. How do you get a code? I am just spewing out codes left and right for the next large number of hours. Been on for 4 hours. I'll be on for at least 6 more, probably. So lots of codes coming. Swamp. We drew the land. So now we're just going to go turn 2 field. No reason to play map if you can't actually scry yet, so. Seeker Squire, sure.
Perhaps today is a good day to die.
Perhaps today is a good day to die, Worf. Thanks for following the stream, appreciate that. Yeah, no reason to chain roller here. We're gonna play a map and just get our scry going. Sure. Yes, we did. We tromped those dinosaurs. They draw land. It is an overgrown tomb. Stand up feels great. Karn, good at the top. I like Karn a lot on this board state. Karn seems great. Pluskies. Field or Fiery Cannonade? Both are fine. Cannonade bops up the random 2-1s and Chupacabras and stuff pretty well, too. So, Cannonade's surprisingly good against this green-black deck. They're not really like a swarmy go-wide deck, but they do put a lot of junk in play. So, I like this Field-Karn combination. Field defends Karn really well. Arena makes new players happy, standard players happy, but established players don't like change. That is very true. Players definitely fear change. Alright, we're going to upkeep Scribe. It's a mountain, I want that. Cool. It's important to keep your keep using your map every turn if you can, so you can flip it as soon as possible. Alright. So we have Rekindling Phoenix here if we want it. We have Field plus Lightning Strike. I think I like Field plus Lightning Strike. We'll just keep protecting Karn, drawing cards.
I'll make use of that later.
Cannonade's not really necessary right now. We draw a mountain and put another Cannonade into Silver Counterland. See, Karn seems so good in this deck. Like, this deck is working exactly as I thought it would. We played the original version of the deck and got destroyed by green-black, and this game state feels awesome. We have Map and Karn drawing us cards, getting us all set up. It feels great. We're using our spells defensively, but we have card draw, so it actually works. Okay, so they can kill my treasure map, but I just killed the Vivian, so.
I didn't live through hell to use to you.
No, they're not killing the map? That's insane. That seems really, really bad. Doom Whisper is annoying. It's a pretty big one. But I didn't set my stop. It's annoying.
Support what we do.
Yep.
If you're just joining.
Alright. Make a Karn token. It's a 4/4. And then play a Phoenix also. Alright, let's. Lava Coil. Their hand is Doom Whisper, Jade Light Ranger. I think I like Lava Coil. We can also use Karn to get the sweeper back, actually. We can sweep and Lava Coil. Yeah, that's pretty good. I want that. Top. Flip that bad boy. Get some money. Money! Play Phoenix.
Awaken.
They cast Doom Whisperer here. I'm feeling really good. Sure.
Meet my newest friend.
We're coming for you next turn, Vivian Reed. Don't you worry. Sweet. This is going to be a really good turn for us. We draw. Alright, we're going to...
The time has come.
Get my fiery cannonade. Cast it. What's up, Stormbird Dragon? Lava coil this thing. And cast Goblin Chain Whirler. Although he tapped my lands wrong, so I didn't look closely enough at my thing. It's fine. Probably want to draw a card anyway, but... Yeah, that's annoying. Bad land tap. Whatever. That's my fault. That's not Arena's fault. Chain Whirler. And 4 and 3. What do you guys think? Good turn? Raise your hand in chat. I think that was a good turn.
I've seen squirrels.
Alright. Karn's great. Cool. This deck's cool. I like it. Against them, what do we want? We probably want to cut... I don't know. Shocks? Yeah. I'll take out a cannonade. And then we want to know if we want, like, frenzies and fight with fires, I guess. Karn's good. Phoenix is good. I don't want an insane amount of frenzies. We also don't need an insane amount of removal, either. Shock hits stuff, but I think they're just playing Lightning Strike is better. It just does more damage. You know, like... Free Fight with Fires. I'm going to cut... I think Lava Coil is pretty good, actually. Just exiling stuff's kind of nice. I put in a third Frenzy. So 3 Frenzy, 3 Karn, 4 map. It's a good card draw engine, I think. Let's try this. I'm not really sure, honestly, but... Carnage Tyrant's a problem, for sure, but... Flame of Keld sucks. Flame of Keld's just a very bad magic card. Right, we can just fight with fire and kill them for 10. Yeah, we can keep this. I am concerned with the card Carnage Tyrant in particular, but, alright. Let's draw a land, please. Our next 2 draw steps. Get this Chain Whirler going. Kill this Llanowar Elf. Wild Growth Walker's good. Cab, new sub. Cab, what's up, everyone? What's your name? Where are you from? Good God. Just draw a land, please. We Lava Coil the Walker or Lightning Strike it? I like Lava Coil to make sure it's gone. They can't recur it with something. You know what? No, we're going to strike it. They have another Walker and 1 Explorer effect, then the Coil can still kill it, so... Miss, 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 miss. Damn. Flame of Keld is just really bad in general. I think that's a card that people missed on really hard, that people thought was good. It was actually just terrible. Land, 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 land. Damn it. Okay. This is getting awkward. New sub, Squishy Butt. What's up, my friend? Everyone likes a good Squishy Butt.
What the hell is that?
Garage!
I didn't play field because I want to kill this 3-2. I guess I could just play the field. Sure. Yeah, playing field's probably better. They also could have Chupacabra in their hand too, which lets them commit to the board better. I guess Chupacabra would kill the Chain Whirler. Yeah, I should play the field. That was wrong. Oh my god. Please don't have Carnage Tyrant. Please don't have Carnage Tyrant. Please don't have Carnage Tyrant. I guess we have two Chain Whirlers in our hand. Cast down? Sure. Can you draw a land, please? I do wish there was a turn counter on Magic Arena. Just like, you know, turn your turn, parentheses, turn four. Something like that, you know? So you can quickly see what turn it is. One Whirly Boy. Sweet. My fourth land. Assassin's Trophy is so bad. Feeling pretty good about this one, I'm not gonna lie. Chupacabra, it's not bad. Then we have his Phoenix or Karn. I like Karn. Karn keeps the lands flowing, keeps the cards flowing. We have plenty of gas here, just keep them busy. Karn's great. Alright, they hold Chupacabra. What's plus Karn again?
Good choice.
So I have Phoenix, they Chupacabra, I can cannonade both creatures. Wait, actually, they're not gonna Chupacabra the Phoenix. They only have one card in hand? Yeah, this is actually just a joke, so this is fun. Yeah, I mean, when Flame of Keld works properly, it is good. The problem is it rarely works properly, and it's unbelievably awful when it doesn't work properly, so. Alright, this is fine. This takes three. Goes to one. Now what? Like, if Flame of Keld was 2 mana, a delayed draw 2, it would still not be good. And that's like the best case scenario of not discarding your hand. Alright, they plus it and say go, it's fine.
Are you certain of your decision?
Ooh. Frenzy or Lava Coil? They gave us the Frenzy, interesting. Yeah, stack Vraska. Play nothing. We'll Lava Coil the thingy. We could kill a Cannonade, but we can just hold on to the Cannonade. We're not Land Rush. 5. We're not also interested in casting the Frenzy either. So we can just. We're in a really good board state here, so we're not really upset. They need to draw a Veraska's Contempt. I guess they could always Chupacabra and kill the Phoenix, but we just have a million things anyway. It doesn't really matter, so. Sweet. This deck seems much better. We got destroyed by Green Black with the old version of his deck, and we just won pretty handily there. That feels good. Bears tuning in, welcome to the stream. My name's Jim Davis. We're playing Arena all day, courtesy of Wizards of the Coast. Thanks, sponsorship. Appreciate that. Wizards was kind enough to give me a bunch of gems and packs so I could play some standard. And here we are. We're playing This is a deck that went 6-4 at the Pro Tour. It was a big red deck playing Demanding Dragon and 4 Banefires. We played that, went 1-2. It seemed awful, so we fixed it. And now we're 2-0. Deck list is in chat, of course. If you haven't followed the stream, hit that follow button. Of course, watching on YouTube, make sure you follow on there. Why didn't I play with Chain Whirler? I could have. And they could Chupacabra it, but it just doesn't matter. You just couldn't lose that game, so whatever. But yeah, that the original version of his deck seemed really bad. How can you have packs? I have booster pack codes to give away. You want some more booster pack codes? Is that what you want? Are we begging in chat now? Are we begging? More codes are coming. Are you ready for them? The codes are coming. Here they come. All right. Put this code into Arena. Get free booster packs. There's 4 codes there. Mulligan. Yikes. We're going to keep. We have a Scry. Alright. Got to draw a land. Main deck Duress. Well, we have 2 maps, so... we missed. Alright. Discovery. C2, I don't really get it either. But I'm giving them out, people are getting free packs, so... Everyone's happy. There are sideboards in competitive play, yes. Okay, so we can go field or map here. We're going to go map. We'll upkeep Scry. Ooh, search for Escanta. Sure. Upkeep Scry land, please. Yes. Map number 2. Blood Operative? Sure.
If I'm not back in 5 minutes, just wait longer.
Oh, I didn't set my stop again. Crap. God damn it. That's really annoying. Stop resets every time? That's a problem. Alright. I guess we're just playing the field. Doom Whisperer is a problem. That's a very large creature. So we need a second removal spell to deal with this Doom Whisperer. Mid-range black decks seem very good against the red decks. They have good answers to Rekindling Phoenix. They have large creatures. It's problematic. I'm not going to cast the Phoenix. Just too likely they have a Contempt and they just mush through. I want to keep using Treasure Map and try and find a second burn spell to kill this Doom Whisperer. I could have flipped search there, but just surveilled once or twice. It's kind of weird. Hence that Scry. another map. I'm going to bottom that. I'm trying to draw some, or a lava coil or something. Scry. Bottom. Alright. Upkeep. Scry. I do like map a lot, I'm not gonna lie. I'm a big treasure map fan. It's not what we were looking for. Removal spell. Do what C2 says in chat. I mean, this is almost assuredly gonna get countered or die or something, but if you use a booster code, say what code you used and what card you opened. Do it for science. Yeah, obviously they have contempt. We could lightning strike our own Phoenix here, but the problem is we need the lightning strike to deal with the Doom Whisperer. So I'm gonna let this happen, I think. We also lose two treasures, and that's less cards you can draw, so. And turn them all to stone. The codes were in chat. Alright, they have found Azcanta. And a Blood Operative. God, give me a Chain Whirler, please. No, I don't want you. I want the actual kill spell. We gotta kill this Doom Whisperer. Oh, oops. I mean, I feel like they should be surveilling much more aggressively. They have so much life. They're just never using it ever. New update, not sure. Upkeep, scry. Another Phoenix? Alright, that's fine. Money! Just pray they don't have a another contempt or counterspell here. Tilt! Well, we're dying. Shock. Suppose it keeps us alive. So again, we should draw any removal spell that deals 3 damage or more. And we can maybe survive here. Exiling our Phoenix, you got it. Man, we are bricking off here. Upkeep for what? There's no maps in play. Oh my god! Help me! Now we're just dead, it doesn't matter. Yeah, this Chain Whirler, but we can't beat the 6-6. That's pretty annoying. So our deck is definitely weak to a 6-6 flyer. It's not a very popular card in the format right now, but that's okay. just died to Doom Whisperer and literally Doom Whisperer alone. Yes. Arena will be on mobile, and I can't wait till it is, because that'd be a lot of fun, playing on my iPad and stuff. All right. That game was unfortunate, and we are definitely soft to Doom Whisperer, but we can't really do much about it, honestly. So, Cannonade's got to go. Shock also bad. Fight with Fire can team up with stuff to kill it, I suppose. I want some Frenzies, and I guess some Banefires. Nah, there's no Star of Extinction. It could be in the deck. That might be it's probably a 2 of in the sideboard, I would think, for Carnage Tyrant. I just didn't consider it when I was building the deck. Or changing the deck from the original build. I suppose Lightning Mare is actually okay, right? Oh, War Boss. What am I doing here? Let's get aggressive. Let's cut the... What's going on? One of the War Bosses... Maybe cut the field. I think I got the fields, actually. Add 2 strikes. Want a Lightning Mare, too? Excuse me. I think you want to be aggressive. So... Too many Frenzies. Oh, I got a Karn, too. I have no idea if this is right or not. We're 1-0 with this version of a deck. The version from the actual Pro Tour went 1-2. It seemed terrible. Yeah, I think I agree there should be 2 Star of Extinction in the board. I mean, no Thought Erasure, please. Obviously. See, our 5 land hand does not play well against Thought Erasure, but. Yeah, I wanted that War Boss, I'm not gonna lie. Frenzy ain't bad. Definitely like Frenzy. Alright, we're slamming Frenzy. It's obviously not ideal, but they can't counter it. They can't remove it. We'll just get it in play and just go nuts. We end up building up a, you know, bevy of burn spells in our hand. We can just pop it later. So, StarCraft 2. I love StarCraft 2. Can I play StarCraft? Tempt my Chain Whirler. All right. Frenzy time. First ball up, a mountain. Next ball up, a mountain. Come on. We have 3 mountains in our hand. We go mountain, mountain. That's sick. Okay. That's fine. I don't really understand the purpose of that. They just freed my hand up, but sure. Do we play a land out of our hand? I don't think so. Actually, we don't have any 1-drops in our deck. Yeah, I'll play the land. Heh. I'm smart. Top 5 cards in Standard? I'm not sure. Obviously, History's insane. Eldestraborn! Man. Poor Horsey. Kindling Phoenix. Mountain. Lava Coil. Frenzy is definitely not as good in this deck as it is in the red deck. Not all of our cards are proactive. So it's definitely a thing, you know. Okay. Mountain. We're also playing more lands in your average red deck too, so Frenzy is definitely not great in this deck. What are they getting back? Legion War Boss. All right. You've seen 2, 8, 9, 10. We've seen 10 mountains over. Disinformation campaign. Sure. Please, just F6 to turn. Top guard, mountain. Lightning Mare. Lava Coil. I guess I can't see the top card before I announce the casting of it. Hmm. You gotta kill the operative, I think. Just exiles it. Another mountain? Why are you doing this to me? Another copy of Disinformation Campaign. Whatever. Top guard, Karn. That's not great, that's okay. Karn, okay. Phoenix, okay. Land, okay. Legion War Boss, nope. Can't pay for it. We're mana short. Alright. Make a token.
Evil cannot withstand a righteous arm.
Thought Erasure. This doesn't make any sense. Do I want to just let Karn take one? Or go to one and make that's minus two, make a token? Alright, yeah, let's block. What?
Please stop.
Did you say please stop? That's funny. Land. Goblin Chain Whirler. Should have waited. Another land. Alright. Let's clear the top with Karn.
I'll make use of that later.
Land. Good. Don't have many lands left, honestly. Lava Coil. Fight with Fire. We're going to obviously keep that in our hand, and then we're going to pop this end step and kill them with it, probably. So that feels nice. do they get? Sure. So, barring a counterspell, they're just like super dead, which is great. They're probably gonna waste all their mana on playing these stupid things. Yep. I think we're good here. So our frenzy isn't ideal in our deck. It's still good. Right, they got sabotage. They have no land to play it, right? Hopefully. The experiment is over. I could have negate, I suppose. This is game one, right? That's just unreal. Okay. Well, this is game one, right? To main deck negates their deck? Sure. Alright, whatever. Oh, it's game two. Okay, right. I guess negate's okay against us. That's fair. Alright, sure, whatever. They had sabotage in their hand. If we're gonna go for it, we gotta go for it. That's fair. Main deck has Kanta, Thought Erasure. I mean, they're just dead because they're dirtling with this stupid card because this card sucks. This information campaign is so bad. It's like the darling of Arena and FNM players everywhere. Upkeep stop. Good catch. Just dirtle while you die. Upkeep. War boss. Sure. Play this. They counter it. Get a Phoenix off my silver counter.
Your patience is rewarded.
I go to one. Come on, Magicka Arena, you can do it. Yeah. One of my Pro Tour predictions was this card would be nowhere near the top tables, and I was correct. Very popular card in Arena. I said it's the kind of card where the best player at FNM will crush everybody with it because they're playing like a reasonable deck full of good cards, but it's actually just too slow for competitive play. Slam, what's up, new sub? Welcome. Alright, I actually want more frenzies, I think. Maybe we're not going to be that aggressive. Maybe we just don't want. So they have negates, Eldest Reborns, Temps. I guess the Mares were fine. Five of Fire, they have negates. Five of Fire is actually bad. Yeah, let's do like Frenzy. We'll just play all of our good stuff. And we'll just try and beat Doom Whisper somehow. I don't know. I guess Banefire is actually fine too. Maybe we cut a Karn and a Frenzy for a Banefire, for two Banefires. Karn's so good though. Nope. Maybe just two Frenzies. Two Karns, two Frenzies. Two Karns. Yeah, Blue Black is not particularly great. I think it is very good against mid-range red decks, which we are playing. It was also my video on Monday. I played a Rakdos mid-range deck. But I think on the whole, they're just not very good. I'll keep this. Lockets are really, really bad, yes. Yeah, I believe there was a Demir deck that went 7-3 and had one disinformation campaign in the main deck. We don't need to cut lands. Frenzy's still good, even if we're not if our hits aren't perfect. Triple Island? I didn't upkeep, whatever. I'm not gonna cast anything. I think they would love to cast the Counterspell and Surveil, because they're obviously mana screwed. So I'm just not gonna let them do it. It's just they go. Demir Guildgate, sure. Are on top. Okay, now I want to resolve Karn, so I'm fine playing the map. All right, it worked anyway, so cool.
Fresh meat.
No Doom Whisperer either, so that's dope. Thought Erasure? Alright, that's obviously annoying, but whatever. Again, I feel like the crowd on Arena is a little more casual, and like I said, this is like the perfect FNM deck. It has a lot of power to it, so your above average player at the store will just crush everyone with it. But it's not actually good enough. Your opponent's decks are all actually good also. Cycle, thanks for following. Bottom that. I spoke about it in my article last week. I'm fine with this.
Welcome aboard.
Very happy to have my curve float around my maps here. Essence Scatter, sure. Now we're flipping our maps. We have Karn ready to go. Disinformation campaign, whatever. We're just going to Lightning Strike. Biggest difference between Friday Night Hero and a pro is play-wise. Everything, honestly. Just general understanding of the game. And understanding why things work and what and the reasons why they're doing all the things they're doing. Oh, it lagged. I didn't upkeep. I had my stop set. That's annoying. Alright, it just lagged. And I thought I was still the end step, so I didn't scry. That sucks. Okay. That's really annoying. Could have a negate. There's just lag when I hit the space bar. Wouldn't matter anyway. I would run Shrine Mountain. All right, I'll just try Karn. If they have a negate, they have a negate. All right, that's fun.
I do not feel pain.
Drawing a lot of cards over the next few turns, so. Alright, well, we gotta find a removal spell and kill this thing with Lava Coil and a Burn spell. Yeah, we're casting Karn. Obviously, we'd love Karn to resolve, but, like, them countering Karn there is not the end of the world. Relentless, I mean, perhaps to an extent. Destroy is a pretty strong verb. They have so many cards in hand. I think his Phoenix is just dead to rights. I should have fought a burn spell. I don't even want it. Oh my god, there's just so many mountains. Siege Gang or Rabble Master? Siege Gang. Rabble Master is not good in a goblin deck. So he makes all your goblins attack. Can you draw a spell, please? Is that possible? This is unreal. Alright, well, now we're in trouble, because then I get to untap. This card's also terrible with the counterspell. It's like you're like sorcery speed playing things. You also have this counterspell. Like, he's the mirrored action is really bad. Alright, well, let's discard a mountain. Only 10 mountains so far. Oh, that's 11. How about 12? Make it 12 mountains? Show me 12 mountains. I want to see it. Banefire. What are they at? They're at 18. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It's only... Yeah, I'm just going to kill this Doom Whisperer now. That's fine. This place... We have a bunch more draws. We have two more cards in play, effectively. We're fine. If I play 1,000 games of a 75-card mirror with the deck of my choice against Nassif, what do I think that my win rate would be? That's a very leading question. I mean, Nassif's obviously really, really good. It's hard to say. I'd say between 45 and 50%. Maybe I'm overvaluing myself. I don't really know. Between 40 and 50%. Where? I'm not exactly sure. Control later? Probably not. So they get to get this back. Don't play another Doom Whisperer. That's fine. You can futz around with these all you want. Discard a mountain! Draw a card. It's actually unreal. Alright. No! Undo! That's what I meant to do. Hashtag sponsor. This is actually unreal. There's 1, 2 mountains in our graveyard. There's 8 in play. 9 in play. Unreal. If it was Legacy Goblin's Mirror, I'd say 60-40 me. Like, it depends on the matchup, obviously, but 70 is also really high, too. Like,
how did you get here? We
entered a contest. Start a mountain. Imagine if they had no removal spell here. No, they do, obviously. Controls the undoes. This is actually unreal. We have Banefire in our deck, I suppose. Unmoored Ego. Okay. All the Rekindling Phoenixes in my deck are now gone. That's not even the best card we have. If we draw a Frenzy, our entire deck is spells. So, I would name Frenzy, honestly. Ah, crap. It's obviously have a counterspell. Ugh. Whatever, we're playing it. No! We'll draw Frenzy. Well, Chris, apparently you do want to talk about it because you just put it in a chat room with 400 people, so. Should have baited them with Lava Coil. They would never counter the first Lava Coil. They would just counter the second one, so it's not really bait. Like, all right, here we go. I mean, whatever. Like, this is mine. Relentless. You were digging me? I didn't even notice. What'd you say? What was the dig? I missed it. Alright. I wonder if we'll win this game. We have Banefire for 12. Unfortunately, that's not really enough. When I said FNM guys could beat pros, right. Obviously anyone can win a Magic, you know. Destroy is a little much, you know. I think you're underselling it a little bit, you know. All right, well, I guess we kill this Doom Whisperer. A million. We're actually pretty close to killing them, honestly. Heard free codes and coupons, that's right. That's right, this is the place. How do you name Phoenix? What a terrible name with Unmore Ego. Like, Banefire is better, Frenzy's better. Yeah, we gotta restart Arena too. It's getting a little slow. Oh, they've killed my creature. It's getting really slow. Jesus. Still in beta. Still in beta. Oh, mountain. Okay. Sure. Can we deck them? I imagine they have more Doom Whisperers, so probably not. Two more mountains and a Banefire. I believe there's one more Banefire in my deck. Right? I didn't use a Banefire earlier, did I? I did. There's no Banefires left. Could be in trouble, folks. One Whirly Boy. Just gotta resolve a Frenzy. You know? Yeah, obviously you want to talk about it, Chris. Come on. Ritual of Soot, sure. Let's search for treasure. Not a bad draw, actually. Engage, sure. Plow on the road here for a possible Frenzy. It's two sabotage, two negates so far. The Immortal Sun drawing Karn 100% of the time. Nope, it's a mountain. Yeah, we crushed with the LSV deck. Worst Elders Reborn of all time.
If I'm not back in 5 minutes, just wait longer.
Lightning Strike. Can you say upstairs? I know, one more Banefire, we'd be fine. There were four Banefire in the main deck of his deck before, but that's just like awful. They didn't end step Escanta? Alright, whatever. Oh, we gotta restart Arena here. I love how we're like 5% to win this game, maybe more, and they literally have everything they could ever want in play. And we have 13 mountains in play, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4 in the bin. Can't counter this one. Hold on, here she comes.
Wise man say, forgiveness is divine, but never pay full price for late pizza.
Sure. They have 10 cards in it. We might. Alright, so, but now they get the 9-9 back, though, or 6-6, so we're just dead, so. Doesn't really matter. We would need Frenzy into multiple removal spells. We have 8 cards left. I just want to draw a mountain. Give me that mountain. Nope, Lava Coil. Alright. So like I said, I don't think these black mid-range decks are very good at all. But they are good against red mid-range decks, unfortunately. You know, we played red-black Rakdos. I played Rakdos on my Cool Stuff video. I lost to Grixis. And now, yeah. Almost won that game, too. Which is actually insane. But, alright. So we are 1-1. Right? 2-1. With our fixed version of the Big Red deck. If you're tuning in, welcome to the stream. Of course, CoolStuffInc.com. My home on the web, CoolStuffInc.com. Videos Monday, articles every Friday. And of course, CoolStuffInc.com, your home for all your Magic stuff, singles, boxes, as well as all your gaming stuff as well. Promo code JIM5, get 5% off your next order. I'll restart after this league. I want to finish the league up nice and clean. Do I have a link with all the codes that I have posted? No, I'm just putting them in chat. Want some more codes? Is that what you want? Is that what you want? Some more codes? Alright, we can do more codes. Keep. Bam. 3 more codes in chat. Those are all 1 booster pack on Arena. Go get them. 1 booster pack on Arena. Yes, Banefire is good against the bad deck in the format. That is correct. We're looking to build our deck to be good against the good decks. So, we're playing Water again, obviously. So, what? I have a stop. It's right there. You saw me hit that stop, didn't you? It was yellow. You saw that. All right. We should not have drawn this mountain. I'm going to call somebody. I'm mad. Was yellow. Very rude. Very rude. Planes. Thought Erasure. Yeah, whatever. Another black deck. I was too slow on it. Is that what you're saying? Is it not fast enough? Fast as lightning. Sure. That's fine. Sweet airship. The part is Draken. Is this Lord Draken? You're playing against Moderator Extraordinaire, Lord Draken? Thanks for following, everyone. Bottom Shock. God, I love Treasure Map. It's a great card. Upkeep. Scry. Tarn Top. Draw. Main Phase. Karn. Karn, a Karn, Karn, Karn. Don't negate my Karn, please, please, please. Alright, I'm making a creature here. They can tempt, we can just attack them. Tempt my Karn, sure. Alright. End step map. Frenzy on top. Ship it. Five mountains. Frenzy. Top card, mountain. Next card, also mountain. I suppose it doesn't really matter. Top card. Another mountain. It's okay. We're kicking it here. We got a 6-6, we got Frenzy going, we got Cove and Clues and all sorts of good stuff. Karn, 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 Karn. Ritual of Soot to kill my 6-6, sure. Yeah, codes are coming. You just gotta watch the stream. Cleansing Nova would be insane. I have no one drops in my deck, so there's no reason to draw a card. What's up, Furry? Alright, here we go. Burst Ball up. We're Kindling Phoenix. We're gonna tap one of these. Bird. I do like drawing mountains, apparently. There's a mountain. Fiery Cannonade. I guess we just cast the Fiery Cannonade, right? Like, just cycle through it, whatever. Lava Coil? Ugh. Again, Frenzy not great in this deck, as far as the main deck goes, in matchups like this. I don't even want to draw it. I'm just gonna say go. I'll have to stack my clues. Yeah, just say go. Alright, they have found Escanta. And again, Phoenix is not great against the black decks as they have Contempt. So once again, we're playing against the black deck. Not really a big part of the metagame, but good against us. We're going to fight through, though. We're going to power through. Top card, treasure map. Sign me up. Perfect. Mountain. Another mountain on top. That's fine. Treasure map. Bottom. Top cart. Chain whirler. Do it. Top card mountain. Okay, so no settle. That's good. Mountain. And another mountain. I just love mountains so much. Give me more mountains. I love them. They're my friends. Agree. Maybe Frenzy's more of a sideboard card than a main deck card. See, it's still good in these matchups, but I don't think you want it in the main deck. What? I didn't do that. What's up, Boyst? Welcome. 25 is a lot. We are playing a mid-range deck. We've got to make our land drops, you know? Contempt the Phoenix. All right. I guess we could have mapped there in response, trying to find a lightning strike to kill it, but it's a lava coil anyway. Oh, lava coil. Mountain. Shock you. Field. And a mountain on top. We need a seismic assault, that's what we need. Phoenix! Yep, that's fine. Yeah, definitely not a good Immortal Sun deck. Karn has been really, really good. So, again, this deck seems very geared towards beating the top decks in the metagame. You know, your mono white decks, you know, your Boros decks. Seems fine against the Drake deck, I would think, with the four lava coils and removal spells. Ritual of Soot, sure. It does seem like it has a much bit harder time against these control decks, which weren't really a big part of the metagame at the Pro Tour. I didn't set my stop. Oh, never mind, we're stupid. A second Frenzy, sure. A lightning strike. Upstairs. There's more codes coming. God, people are code crazy. Sure. Karn.
Holy crap, dude.
Make creature. Raise your hand in chat if you like codes. Can't only Phoenix. You just can't lose these games with Frenzy in play, so That's pretty good. Sure. Mush says, I made a clever joke earlier, no one seemed to care. Repost it, and I'll read it. Tag me in it, though, so I can see it. I know, we're going to reopen Arena. Memory loss is a problem. The old mana leak, you know?
Some solutions must be built.
Look for them mountain codes, huh? You sure do love those mountains. Alright, well. Oh, I have a chain ruler in my hand, I could pop. No, I'm gonna do that, never mind. Alright, well, then, Mush, I'm not gonna read it then. What do you want from me? And no one will see your joke that nobody laughed at, you know? Alright, so. They're at one. We do have a chain whirler. Probably gonna pop one of the frenzy, sure. Richard loves it, yeah. Why is our bot still playing? Like. Top card, Lava Coil. Despite the bad matchup, we still win. Yay. As long as there's no Doom Whisperers or Fast Clocks, I think we're actually fine against these control decks. We can call it garbage now, too. Like the Lava Coils go, the Shocks go, the Fields go, the Cannonades go, and our Tyrant Cyborg comes in. Four Lightning Mare. Nope, not Lava Coil. Four Legion War Boss, Frenzies, Bane Fires, Fight with Fires. Yeah, this all looks good to me. Hey folks tuning in, welcome to the stream. My name is Jim Davis, welcome. And we're playing some Arena, that's right. Sponsored Wizards creator. Thanks so much to Wizards for hooking me up with the goods in Arena. We got a lot of packs and gems and stuff. Thank you so much. Arena's a lot of fun. It's still beta. We're still working on it. Not everything's perfect. You're seeing some bugs here and there. There's a little bit of a memory leak. It's not totally there yet, but the intangibleness of having a lot of fun playing Magic on the internet is there, and I'm looking forward to it. So, have I ever Banefired someone for 20? Yeah, you must not watch my YouTube videos. You ever seen the greatest game of all time? Hop on YouTube, all right? That's my channel. Almost 18,000 subscribers. Y'all are awesome. And watch this video. The greatest game of Magic ever. All right?
I'm a little sad at those two losses, honestly.
Check it out. You won't regret it.
Those are not like
the greatest game of Magic ever. Keep. Codes, please. Everyone's so needy. Yes, sir. May I please have a code? More codes coming, don't you worry. I win this game, I'll put some more codes in chat. So, cheer for me to win this game. Alright, we're going beat down. Give me a horsey. What's up, Tyler? Predictions went pretty good. Bird. Do I think Arena will implement a system for arbitrary looping? I don't know. Maybe. HQ time. HQ trivia is a lot of fun. I'm not going to play on stream, but I did win a lot of money on Sunday. They do HQ is an online trivia. What am I doing? I didn't cast the War Boss. That's fine. They have a counterspell. It's fun. Diablo playthrough is really cool. So, yep. Duress. I knew what I was doing. I'm smart. But yeah. they do an HQ game. Usually it's like a $5,000 prize split among thousands of people. They do a game where only the top 100 players win. So there were like 70 winners, and Nicole and I won. I won $367. Pretty awesome, right? Alright, I'm going to rock a War Boss now, I think. I could play double map, but yeah, I want to go War Boss here. They counter it, they counter it. Sure. Yeah, I do think one thing I would like to see in Arena is that the daily quests would award the dual lands as prizes. Because dual lands are so important, and it feels bad to craft them, so... Listen, you don't like the shilling, you gotta go somewhere else, right? This is my job, this is my full-time gig, this is what I do for a living. So I pay the bills. So there's gonna be a lot of shilling here. If you don't like that, it's just not gonna work out, alright? Alright, Thief of Sanity's busted. Nerd's Rope is so good. Alright, I mean, Thief is really good, but we're kind of killing them, so... Will there be arena tournaments? I believe so. There's gonna be a lot of stuff. They're still in beta, you know, so... God, Thief of Sanity is so unbeatable. Random hockey fact. Alright. Why is Lightning Mirror in his deck? It's in the sideboard. I don't know. It was in the original list, and I didn't change the sideboard too much, so. Again, this is my version of a deck that went 6-4 at the Pro Tour. It's the list seemed really bad, honestly, so I fixed it. ML, new sub. What's up, my friend? Welcome. They blew the Contempt, which is nice. So hopefully they don't have another Contempt. This fairy's good.
I know my response. I am not going to sit this one out.
I was much more mountain. Bye. Sure. Oh wait, no! They're gonna hit- No! I didn't consider that. I'm so stupid. Teferi to Teferi plus Thief of Sanity is insane. That's so funny. Alright. They stole my Phoenix. Or the Mountain King. I should not have scryed before the Thief, obviously. I should have scryed instep.
Stop that. Don't make another move.
I think we're still okay here. The Phoenix dies. It's not like they get it back, you know? This hurts so good. Yeah, it's been sloppy a few turns. What are you gonna do? Yeah, it's good. Don't think Karn is what we're looking for right now. I'm gonna bottom that. Are you kidding me? Alright. So that's a really annoying bug. If you hit the button to set the stop, but there's no actions between when you... I took my last action, it was still doing the animation, and then I went to hit my upkeep stop, and it just blasted right through it. That's pretty annoying. Again, it is in beta. We drew a good card, it's not the end of the world, but that's pretty annoying. I think we're okay here, barring a contempt. All right. How stupid am I doing? I guess we're blocking. Yeah, I should have scried. I don't know what I was doing. Alright. I'm just bane fire them out, you know? Legion War Boss. That's not really doing it. I'm just gonna bottom that. Hello. Yeah. That place. Kick it. Five, two, three. We do lose some of our treasures, but it's fine. Seems worth it. Suddenly, pandas! Pew, pew, pew. I guess they get the token, right? So, it's like a little annoying, but... Why hit the bird? Because the bird won't come back because there's no phoenix in their graveyard. So now they have an 0-1. Rather than a 4-3 flyer. Bird! It's alright. We got bane fires tonight. We got cards to draw here. We got time to kill. Keep up the pace. Punts over punts over punts. Look, when I actually play bad, you can make fun of me, but that was not that was not one of them. All right, let's draw. Ooh, that's pretty good. We hold the mountain. Codes over codes over codes. That one card better not be a counterspell. Sure. No negate. Contempt. Alright. Top card, another frenzy. Alright, we're gonna cast it. his insurance against Teferi, so we do lose a clue for it, but never treasure. Top card, Phoenix. Alright. Phoenix on top is just actively bad because they have Contempt in their hand. But... oh, I'm sorry. Never mind. It goes to our hand. We're good. Insight. Yeah, do your thing. Yeah, Magic Online's not exactly the best. That's why Arena's here. Draw Phoenix. Top card, Mountain. Next card, Lightning Strike. Upstairs. Top card, Lightning Strike. This is going to make them contempt their own token or counter it. Why not draw Frenzy? Because I want to have two Frenzies in play, so if they wanted to ferry one, I still have two. How about another Lightning Strike? Upstairs. Top card, Frenzy. Sinister... a sabotage. Yep. All right. Draw a card. Karn. Karn's fine. Make creature.
Our actions be idle, but evil cannot withstand a righteous army.
We need to move quickly.
Murmuring Mystic? That's a card. Okay. This is not a bad turn for them. Mystic, Craving, Contempt. It's gonna feel real bad when I draw Banefire and kill them. We're 11, too. This is actually like a pretty significant clock. Alright. Yeah. Come on. Come on. Top card, Mountain. Next card. Mountain. God, I hate everything.
No time for a break.
What's the ferry on? Eight? Ugh. I think we're in trouble, folks. Thought erasure, yeah, whatever. Anyone, codes? Give me codes. Fine, I'll give some guys some codes, alright? You want some codes? Two more codes on the way. Alright, bam. Codes, there you go. Happy? Free booster packs in chat. On Arena. Put your code in. Hurry up, though. This loser. Hi. You're not a loser. Big draw step, please. Give me that Banefire. Chain Whirler. That plays. No counterspell. Banefire. It's only for six. We're one short. it resolves, we win. They wouldn't have escanted first if they didn't need a counterspell. Use more than one code? Does that work? Cool. I don't know how the codes work. They give you packs and stuff. All right, we got a hold here. If Whirler resolves, killing all their creatures is buys us infinite time, so it also makes such a fairy as an ultimate. Oh my god, they drew Sinister Sabotage. That's so unbelievably sick. Six, seven. So we can Banefire them and put them to one. They do have life gain effects though. Oh man. We can't even pop both friends. If I had 8 mana, I could just end step, pop both frenzies, draw Banefire, and kill them. But I'm gonna say go. Hence me saying pop one last turn. Yeah. I don't think you want to pop a frenzy there.
I'm sorry I have to do this.
Alright. They have an insight in the graveyard too. Please kill my frenzies. Nope, they're smart. Obviously, they don't want all their birds to die from the Chain Whirler. Like, it also stops the Teferi ultimate. The Chain Whirler was very, very good. There's no sniping. You people are so quick to call out sniping. It literally made it so Teferi didn't ultimate and killed their entire air force. Now we just can't win, so it doesn't matter, really. It's so annoying. What's going on? Okay. Now I'm gonna pop a frenzy on that lethal Banefire. I think we just leave the frenzies and try and get lucky. Alright. Let's go. Lucky time. Mountain. Lightning strike. Frenzy. Ah, that was close. Alright. That's fine. I probably could play the game better. Well, guess we gotta restart Arena. It's still a beta. We're still in beta. Look at this promo while I do stuff. Is that our second loss? 10% off your PCW gaming supplies. Code GYM10, please. And I'll give some more codes in chat while we're waiting here too, alright? Bam. There's some more codes. Try and reload that one. Yes, maybe I should have killed the frenzy instep. Definitely possible. Thanks for following. If you haven't followed, hit that follow button, of course. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Playing a little arena. Just reloading right now. Reload. Reload. Give it my booster pack codes. Unsilent Ninja says, I love BCW Deck Guard Elites now. I got rid of all my Dragon Shields for them. They're sweet sleeves. They are high quality sleeves. We back now? Get ready for game three. Clock's ticking. And the clock is done. Okay, we are going in. The little meter, the clock went over, it couldn't do anything, and it just went, so we're good. I believe it stands for Baseball Card World. I don't use inner sleeves. I'm keeping. Let's finish this off. Finish him. Horsey. Not sure about the horsies, but they beat. Alright, it's a definite. They definitely have a moment of craving here. I'm gonna play the map, try and get Warboss in next turn. Instead of Ack. I hate double sleeving. I think double sleeving is insane. Alright. We got our scry on here. Mountain. I'm cool with that. Now if they counter it or kill it, it's fine. I don't think they have craving anymore. If they only want to use a sabotage on it, it's fine. I have frenzy. I have phoenix. I have better cards in my hand. Syncopate, sure. Step. Another lightning mare. I'm okay with that. I want to map again next turn too, so. Alright. Could have a ritual of soot, I guess. Then we just play Phoenix or a Frenzy. Or that. That works too, I suppose. Karn. I'm cool with Karn. Codes go up whenever I feel like putting them up, so stay tuned. Plus Karn. Our activities are in battle for the forces of good. Draw a mountain, works for me. I mean, now they kind of like have to attack Karn, they can't really kill it. We're in fine shape here. Whoa, hello. Whoa, hello. We can resolve Frenzy here, we're not going to. Sweet, Tower. Hope you guys are enjoying your free booster packs. Attacking me? Okay. Playing any events this weekend? Yep, SCG Las Vegas. Where I'll be. Alright, we gotta find an answer to this Lyra here. Bean fire, fight with fire, something like that. Oh, Lucky, it's my job. Hello, Banefire. Alright, this works for me. Just Banefire the stupid... Wait. No. Attack. Yeah, we gotta kill the Lyra. It's worth it. It's worth it. We have the board. We still have an extra card in play. We have Frenzy in our hand, Phoenix in our hand, Lightning Strike. Feeling pretty good here. What venue is the Las Vegas event? I have no idea. I'm just in Vegas. Sorry, I'm late, he says. So they're 12. And there's another Karn. 6, 7, 8. I guess Karn and Phoenix. That's pretty good. We attack the Fairy or them? We attack the Fairy. Actually, we have Strike too. Alright, yeah, we'll attack the Fairy. That was uncalled for, he says. I should have let on Phoenix, I think. They might have counted the Phoenix, and the Karn is more important. Yeah. It's okay, it's not the end of the world, but... Like, Phoenix is still good, too, but... I think Karn's probably better there. It's a cool Ravik. Guess who's back? Back again. I give out codes all day. Trust me. If you show remorse, let's skip to the good part. Treasure map. Yeah, I mean, Settle's obviously a disaster. Deck Guard Elites are much thicker, nicer sleeves. The Deck Guards are just like kind of like a cheap budget sleeve. I would not recommend them for any sort of like serious competitive play. The Deck Guard Elites are fantastic, though. This is very conservative, but this is what I'm going to do. Okay. Now, we could Fire Breathing here, but I'd rather just use Lightning Strike. It's more mana efficient.
I won't let you win.
Shut up, Teferi. We got basically the world here. Yeah. Top card, Lightning Strike. Upstairs. Next card, Frenzy. I'm gonna bottom that one. Top card, Legion War Boss, come to play. Next card, Phoenix, Ungastable. What's up, Alice? What just happened? Oh, it's such a tilt. Oh my god. So, typically when you just slam the space bar, it's the attack all button. But because the Legion War Boss forces at least one creature to attack, something's already attacking, and then it just goes in as an... Like, spacebar is also the OK button, like pass priority. Alright, that's a tilt. Okay. We're still learning. We're still getting used to the program, you know? I love the space bar. I slammed the hell out of it. Just gotta be aware, you know? Just gotta be aware of these things. You can't be mad at a hammer for smashing your finger if you didn't use it properly, you know? Disdainful stroke. Got it. Yes, the codes are coming. Just keep watching. Jeez. Alright. Phoenix on top. How about attack step? They have settled. God bless them. We're mushing. So you know what? Let's attack with everything but Phoenix. It's still lethal, right? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No pump. Yeah. They say, good game. I say, kill you. Cool. Three and one. This will be a long video. Jeez. Let's go. Play again.
What the hell is that?
I want to keep playing. Once again, if you're sitting, welcome to the stream. How's it going, my friends? Big ups to Wizards for sponsoring me. Make sure you hop on Twitter, give me a follow at JohnDavisMTG. Give me a follow at JohnDavisMTG. Over 9,000 followers. Over 9,000. Going for 10,000 followers for the year. Alright, so hop on there and give me a follow at JohnDavisMTG on Twitter. That's a keep. Thinking. Yes. A difficult turn one, to be sure. Well, I imagine our deck is good against, yeah, that's perfect. This is the matchup we're looking for. Red-white deck. Oop, nope, what's going on? Okay, they're playing a draft deck. Cool. I think the red deck is good against white, yes. Goblin Chain Whirler, still a very good magic card. Ta-da. I should have waited. From the bottom, anyway. Oh, they're running the chain. The chain seems really good against us, actually. Let's get Karn going. Getting a mountain here for sure. It's fine. Fun fact, Aurelia does have two power. Very true. Deuce is wild. Two more codes are in chat. Oh my god.
This will not be good.
History is good. Another Karn is not good.
I'll make use of that later.
Cannonade is great. So they're not going to give us that. We can get it next turn, though. We play Phoenix. They have a Lava Coil here. It's pretty annoying, but Karn will still live. So we can also double Chain Roller next turn, too, which is nice. So that's pretty cool. Matte or glossy? It's the front. All the backs are glossy. The front is either matte or glossy. I like the mattes. Mattes are nice. Isn't posting the code in chat super susceptible to bots? bots stealing the codes. I mean, if someone's gonna write a bot to come in my stupid channel and steal one booster pack from Arena, you gotta just give it to them, you know? Let them have it. They earned it. Legion War Boss. All right. Oh, actually, next turn's better than I thought it was. They're attacking with one Knight token? They have a shock or something? Why not attack with Bolt then? Alright, well, next turn we kill everything, so playing drafts is a good idea. Hello, I am a robot stealing codes. I'm in your computer, stealing your codes. Alright, yeah, I mean, we just minus get back Kennedy, then we cast Chamberlord and kill everything, and life is great. They have the red pump spell? God bless them.
The time has come.
Whirly boy! Story time. No one's here to hear it. Sad. Very sad. Justice Strike, my Chain Whirler. Yeah, we're in good shape here. Legion War Boss, okay. It's fine. God bless him, line. Huh. Jeff says that too. Okay. Upkeep Scry. Bottom. I'm just like token, honestly. Just make two large 5/5s. Oh, you son. I tap the space bar too fast. It's so annoying. I was going to make a token and then cast Karn and make another token and have two 5/5s in play. And now I'm going to have nothing instead. The space bar is great! Just gotta use it right.
Please,
unreal.
I do not feel pain.
Territory, thanks for the raid. Appreciate that. Go ahead, block me, see what happens. No blocks. Alright. I think I like... Let's draw a card. We're still in pretty good shape here. Oh my god, we're so good. We are the nut! Okay. Now we're going to... I guess that doesn't really matter that much as far as Chain Whirler goes, but it's obviously still good, so... Let's do this, plus, let's cannonate them on their turn.
I will fight you. You may regret that choice.
Well, now they give us Lightning Strike, and it feels really good, so awesome. We're going to lose our... Anyway, we should keep a strike. Never mind. I'm being stupid. Another Phoenix. Okay. Alright, now I might use the strike, actually. Okay, so we can strike a Phoenix and then cast Fiery Cannonade. Yeah, this is all perfect. Alright, let's do this. Strike that. Resolve that. Gas cannonade. Everything dies. Karn is fine. Untap, attack, they have to block. We chain whatever token. What's an exile? Oh, we've Quill an exile anyway.
Your patience is rewarded.
Lol. Even despite F6ing our entire turn, we're still in great shape. Donation bonus legs will reopen next week. And like actually next week, not like I'm just gonna say next week. That was easy. Main deck candidates. Who would have thought they'd be good here? Okay. Pelt collector stronger as an O1? Probably not. Let's see here. I think we just leave it. I think our main deck is just perfect for a matchup like this. Yeah, this is fun. I guess I could have brought in the Fight with Fires because they have Lyra. What are good bad matchups for Big Red? It seems good against most of the good decks in the format. It does seem bad against black based mid range decks like Grixis or Blue Black Control. Green Black. The version from the Pro Tour that was playing Demanding Dragon and not playing Karn or Treasure Map seemed awful against Green Black. This version beat Green Black in our first round, so. Not sure. Deck seems good. I like it. Yes, LSV's deck is very good. We 5-0 with that deck earlier this league. Map you. Let's search for treasure. Sure. So that means that I cannot kill the Knight of Grace. Right? Because the way this works. Prevent all non-combat damage. Yeah, okay. Alright. They mentored too. Oh, wait, never mind. We wouldn't kill it anyways. They mentored. Okay. I guess play Field. I can just coil the Tajik, but I want to keep the coil for a Phoenix. Yeah, this is fine. Let's scry too. Shalai? Okay. Tough. Maybe we need Lamb. We gotta bottom that. I mean, I guess we can kill Shalai. If we kill Shalai, we can't kill anything else. Yeah, we gotta make some land drops. Scrybug. Alright, well, I guess we kill Shalai. Oh, wait. Alright, we're gonna bring the Fight with Fires. We're gonna cut the Frenzies, I think. Yeah. That's a lock. Lock step and I'm gone. I'm gonna cut a land, I think. Is that weird? Cut a land and a Frenzy for two Fight with Fires. I'll play three Fight with Fires. I think the Frenzies are not like... We're so reactive. The frenzies are bad when you're reactive, basically, is how it goes. Alright, I'm cool with this. Alright. Yeah. Alright. Field works fine. That's pretty sweet. Just no two drop. Could buy that.
How did you get here?
We entered a contest.
Thanks for following, appreciate that. Welcome.
Holy crap, dude.
History is good. Mountain is bad. I stop with. We're still getting used to the arena, folks. We're still getting used to arena. We're not there yet. But they have a lot of good tools against us. They're a lot better against us than the lower to the ground versions are.
We stand together.
Yeah, that's bad for us.
Strength is born of struggle.
Upkeep, we got it this time. Scry, bottom. Chain Whirler is not particularly great right now. We're about to be taught a history lesson. That's not going to be in our favor. I guess we have Fight with Fire kick next turn, right? We have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I mean, we can Fight with Fire next turn. I don't really want to just, like, play Chain Whirler for nothing, though. We play Chain Whirler and, like, then what? Is our opponent BMing us? That's cool. Can't even block these things. Yeah, I'm just gonna say go. Hello from YouTube. Hi, Mr. Dude Guy. I'm a dude. You're a dude. He's a dude. She's a dude. Yeah. All right. Yeah, let's take a casual 10 here. I suppose. All right. This actually isn't that bad for us. Alright, it's getting worse. Our boss deck is weird. Like, they're playing all the bigger cards, but like, Loxodon feels weird without one drops and two drops, right? Like, just feels weird, I don't know. I mean, it's really good against us, and the post-combat pump. Yeah. Well, we're dead as a doornail, so we're gonna concede. We can't even fight with fire or anything. Alright. I mean, if the white decks go bigger, that's obviously a huge problem for us, but you know, the ones in the Pro Tour did not, so. Star of Extinction could definitely be in the board. I definitely like that card. Alright, so 3-2 with the updated version. Ooh, we got a mythic. Whoop. Yep.
This isn't a fight you can win.
What's up, Teferi? Welcome to the collection. Yeah, so I think the version that we built is much better than the Pro Tour version. The Pro Tour version was not playing Karn or Treasure Map. They were playing Demanding Dragon and Banefire. So it does seem like Banefire is an important tool in your bad matchups, but I like where this is going. I'll work on this more. Don't think you want Frenzy main deck. I can easily play like a Fight with Fire or two main deck, honestly. But overall, seems sweet. So, this is a long video. If you're still watching on YouTube, make sure you follow on YouTube. The video will end, the stream will not. So YouTube, look for this deck more, and see you guys later.